Divorce dogs for training causes headaches even for experienced dog trainers. Why? Characteristics of dogs that make training challenging are independent thinking, stubbornness, independence, and laziness. The goal of this video is not only to show which dogs are the most difficult to train, but also to state the reasons why and offer some guidelines on how to handle the more demanding dog breeds. Before I go on with the list, if you're a new visitor to the channel, please consider subscribing and tell other pet lovers to do the same. Now let's take a look at the list of top 10 worst dogs for training. Dog breed number 10, the Siberian Husky. The Siberian Husky is one of the most beloved and beautiful dog breeds in the world. They are known for their friendly nature and playfulness, but it is not as well known that they aren't the easiest to train. Why? Huskies are friendly toward everyone, energetic, athletic, and peaceful. Training quickly starts to bore them, they can be extremely stubborn, and they don't react well to just anyone trying to train them. They require a strong leader. Huskies have always lived in packs and follow the strongest one among them, their main leader. That's what makes them great as pets, but they are not recommended for beginners and first-time owners. Training should be commenced at an early age, so your husky accepts you as their leader. Dog breed number 9, the Bow Mastiff. The fearless and tough, yet gentle Bow Mastiff demands a strong leader who can set boundaries. Bow Mastiffs are protective, independent, loyal, devoted, careful, gentle, peaceful, and brave. What makes Bow Mastiffs difficult to train is their independence. They like being independent and thinking with their heads. They require early socialization and obedience training so as not to become aggressive, especially toward other animals and strangers. With an early start, consistency, and helped by the positive reinforcements technique, you shouldn't have any problems training them. Dog breed number 8, the Dachshund. The small hunting dog called Dachshund can often be found on these lists of dogs with bad traits. Why? They mostly have their hunting instincts and their stubbornness to thank for their bad list placements. Still, they are small, cute, and quite special, making them a frequent choice for people looking for a pet. Dachshunds are stubborn, smart, devoted, lively, playful, and brave. Here we have a very smart but also stubborn dog breed, which makes them less obedient, especially if they don't happen to find you entertaining. While training the Dachshund, you should have a good knowledge of dog training techniques and only train them for shorter periods. Dog breed number 7, the Shar-Pei. The Shar-Pei is a dog wary of everyone. They can be very independent, which of course makes them difficult to train. These dogs are therefore not for everybody. Cantonese Shar-Peis are careful, polite, devoted, independent, and gentle. Shar-Peis get very attached to one person. That person has to be a leader, but on the other hand, assertive and gentle, and has to try to get to know their dog. In the wrong hands, the Cantonese Shar-Pei becomes a very stubborn, independent, and even dangerous guard dog. Dog breed number 6, the Basset Hound. Basset Hounds are known as good dogs for children. They tend to be friendly toward everyone, intelligent, yet still difficult to train. What's the reason? Basset Hounds are friendly, stubborn, playful, devoted, persistent, and gentle. As you probably guessed, their stubbornness is the main trait that makes them difficult dogs to train. At times, they also get lazy. Their stubbornness and laziness make them unmotivated to learn, and it isn't a rare occurrence for them to simply ignore their owners. However, they have an extremely good sense of smell, and rewarding them with some treats is by far the best training strategy. Dog breed number 5, the Akita. The Akita is a faithful dog and a truly wonderful pet. They are generally reserved, but still devoted, and the love they have for their owners is so great that they have become a symbol of loyalty known the world over. Akitas are protective, sensitive, attentive, independent, calm, and faithful. Characteristics such as independence and frequent stubbornness can make training them a long and demanding process. An Akita must be trained by their owner. Why? The Akita is very faithful, and if trained by the owner, they will form a very special bond for life. They are very sensitive dogs, so you should be careful with them. Do not lose your temper or attack these delicate dogs. Simply dedicate your time to them, be consistent, and you'll find that you can teach them many things without too much difficulty. Your reward will be their devotion and protection for life. Dog breed number 4, the Chow Chow. The Chow Chow has a proud and independent spirit. Experts often cite the breed as demanding and bad for first-time owners, as well as difficult to train. Chow Chows are reserved, loyal, independent, and quiet. They are not the most intelligent, they tend to have a problem with authority, as well as being quite independent. They require an experienced leader who will train them from an early age in order to earn their respect. Any kind of shouting or a harsher method of training has a negative effect on the learning rate of these dogs. Now we will take a look at the top 3 worst dogs for training. The worst dogs for training number 3, English Bulldogs. It is not news to anyone that English Bulldogs are stubborn and remarkably lazy. These small muscular dogs just don't have much motivation for learning. They see nothing wrong with simply lying around the house all day. English Bulldogs are friendly, sociable, stubborn, and lazy. Along with the lack of motivation, they are not the most intelligent dogs, so their owners need to have plenty of patience and love for their pets to train them. Still, many things are achievable. You can find a lot of inspiration and incentive for training in numerous YouTube videos that showcase English Bulldogs as proper little surfers and skaters. So be entertaining, patient, and use plenty of treats when training these dogs. The worst dogs for training number 2, Basenjis. The Basenji is, according to the research, the oldest dog breed in the world that has managed to survive on its own to this day. Therefore, they are intelligent, but the other traits just aren't the best when it comes to training. Basenjis are curious, energetic, intelligent, independent, polite, attentive, and playful. This is a smart but self-reliant dog breed that likes to think with its head. They are also very energetic and love having fun. You must carefully select the place where you plan to train them, because they simply won't listen to you if they find something interesting nearby. One thing that helps with training is that they will usually pick one person to listen to. It is also recommended to be positive in training and to make sure you reward and prize every good behavior when training a Basenji. And now for the most difficult dogs to train in the world, ready? The worst dogs for training are Afghan Hounds. The Afghan Hounds have been known since ancient times for their beauty, dignity, and incredible running speed of around 40 miles per hour, 65 kilometers per hour. Why are they so challenging to train? During a research study, these dogs needed to have commands repeated to them more than 100 times, and they were obedient in less than 25% of cases, which is the worst result of all dogs that were tested. Afghan Hounds are dignified, reserved, independent, and happy. These dogs are very independent and they don't react well to training. They can be extremely unmotivated due to the lack of desire to please their owners, and not even treats help much. The only thing left for owners of Afghan Hounds is to be patient. They will not react well to harsher methods, so it's better not to attempt them. The only thing you will accomplish is non-participation. Your best bet is positivity, a lot of patience, and gentle work with these dogs. As demonstrated, not all dog breeds are inclined to learning and listening to their owners. What can you do? If you do decide to embark on the adventure of owning one of these difficult to train dog breeds, the most important thing is to educate yourself about them and their needs. If you know of any other dog breeds I didn't mention, or you have suggestions or other related information, make sure to leave a comment below the video. Would you like to see more? In the video description, I have prepared links to the top 10 smartest, deadliest, most aggressive, most dangerous, most beautiful, smallest dog breeds in the world, and many more! If you enjoyed this video and found it useful, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss new videos in the future! Let's keep our pets healthy and happy! Bye!